Okay, so let's remember the goal here is to get either x or y to be opposite. And to get a positive 12x and a negative 12x, positive 14y, negative 14y, so that when we add the two equations together, they cancel each other out. We'll do that by multiplying one or both of the equations by something.
5 and 4.
5 and 4.
5 on the top and then 4 on the bottom.
Okay. 5. 4.
And you get 20. Right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then minus 3y equals 8. Oh, wait. Whoops, I forgot.
Yeah, you gotta multiply everything.
Yeah.
I equals 40.
Yeah.
And then this other one,
20x. And then, oh god. Yeah.
Alright. When we add these together, they're gonna cancel out?
No.
No, but we're really close. How do we need to change it?
You need to do quantum and negative.
Right. So we just let's make this one negative. So well instead of having done 4, we'll do -4. And that's a simple fix. -20x, +8y, +44. Smaller, there we go. Now we're ready to go. They're gonna cancel each other out. Make sure one of them is negative. We add them together. 20x plus -20x is 0x. -15y plus 8y is -7y. And make sure we get the try. 40 plus 44.
84.
Divide by -7. Y equals, make sure I got my math right here. 84 divided by 7. That's negative. So y is negative 12, and now that we know the y is negative 12, what do we do with that information?
Plug in the y.
Plug in the y here or here, doesn't matter. 4x minus 3 times negative 12 equals 8. 4x plus 36 equals 8. Subtract 36 from both sides, you get negative 28. Divide by 4, x is negative 7.
Oh.
7, negative 12. Alright, what do you guys think of that? Make sense?
Yeah, I just forgot how you found x. So, like,
okay.
Now, so, we know. I guess what I did to find x is that I just went back and then did.
Oh, did
like
it the
found
way.
Y. Yeah, and then I did 3 and 2.
Ah.
I gotta go 3 and 2. Would that figure it out?
Yeah.
Oh, would? Oh, okay.
It should. Yeah, you should get exactly the same answer. -7, -12. You remember what you got?
Yeah.
Well, it definitely would do the, it would take longer, so we don't want to do that every time, but
yeah. I just didn't know if there was another way, so.
There's so many ways. I mean, we could do substitution, we could use a matrix, but we won't. 7x. Plus 3y equals negative 12. 2x plus 5y equals 38. So again, we're going to get x or y to be opposite each other so we can cancel each other out. So how do we make that happen?
3 and 5.
3 and 5? Which one do we multiply by 3?
The bottom one.
Okay. 3. 5, except we should do something negative, so we'll do negative 3. Alright, so multiply by 5, we get 35x plus 15y equals negative 60. Multiply by negative 3, negative 6x minus 15y, that's what we're going for. Negative, let's see. We add them together, and the y's will cancel each other out. 35x minus 6x is 29x. Negative 60 minus 114 is negative 174. Divide by 29. Numbers are noxiously big. 174 divided by 29. It'll be a negative 6.
Yeah.
X is negative 6, and now we can find that, find y using that. 2 times negative 6, using the second equation here, plus 5 times y. Show me that you get it? Alright. Well, it's I got a piece of paper. And okay, so we want to get the x's and the y's to be opposite, so they cancel and we add them together. You can do it lots of different ways. Let's just throw it out there. What do we do?
2 and 3.
Multiply by 2 and 3. This one by 2 and this one by 3?
Yeah.
Oh,
-3 on the ball.
-3 on the ball. 2 times 7x is 14x. 2 times negative 6y is negative 12y. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. Negative 3 times 5x is negative 15x. Negative 3 times negative 4y is positive 12y. And negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. We add them together, we get 14x minus 15x is negative x. These eliminate each other. Negative 2 minus 3 is negative 5. That tells me negative x equals negative 5, so what does x equal?
Positive 5.
Divide by negative 1 on both sides. And now I'll take this 5, plug it in. 7 times 5 minus 6y equals negative 1. 35 minus 6y equals negative 1. Subtract 35. Negative 6y equals negative 36. Divide by negative 6 and y equals 6. 5, 6. Let's take out our notes and solve another system. Something crazy can happen. First, think about what we're looking for. We're looking for an x and a y, right? A pair of numbers, an x and y.
I just cross those out right now.
Almost. We're looking for a pair, an x and a y, that if I plug that x and y in this equation, it makes it true. And if I plug the same x and y in here, it makes this equation true.
5.
If we multiply by a negative 1 here, we'll get 3x plus 2y equals 10, and a negative 3x minus 2y equals negative 2. If we add them together, and like if we're trying to get the x's to eliminate, what we'll notice is not only do the x's eliminate, the y's eliminate, so what's left on the left side?
Nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
Nothing.
And 10 plus negative 2 is 8.
They called that a thing, like it has no solution, but they gave it like a name for it.
It has no solution. What this system is called is an inconsistent. We don't really need to worry about knowing the word inconsistent. It has no solutions.
It's a paradox.
Now we can see why this system has no solutions. To show you a picture of how you know this has no solutions, I'm going to go all the way back to 7.1, our first attempt to solve a system of equations, and that was with graphing.
Okay.
So I'm going to rewrite each of these equations so they're a little easier to graph. I'll color code them so you can keep track of them a little more easily. So I'm just going to put them in slope-intercept form. So this green one, I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides to get 2y equals negative 3x plus 10. Divide by 2 on both sides. Get y is equal to negative 3 halves x plus 5. Now for the other one. Subtract 3x from both sides to get 2y equals negative 3x plus 2. Divide by 2 on both sides, and I get y equals negative 3 halves x plus 1. Grab a xy axis. So I'll graph both of these. First, the green one has a y-intercept of 5 and a slope of negative 3 halves, so I'm going to add 3 into the right 2. And graph that line. And now for the second equation, y equals negative 3 halves x plus 1 has a y-intercept of 1, and this line also has a slope of negative 3 halves. Down 3 into the right 2.
So it's a parallel line.
Right, these two lines have the same slope. So they're never going to do what?
Cross.
They're never going to cross. And remember back to graphing? We would graph both of them, and what would we look for?
Intercept.
Where they intersected. These two will never intersect. They'll never have a an intersection. They're what you call parallel lines. That's what Cameron said. So they have the same slope, it turns out. And when they have the same slope, they're parallel and they'll never cross. And so there's no
solution.
There's no x and y that these two equations can share that will solve them both. And I think Harvey noticed they looked a little fishy from the beginning. Right? They had we have 3x plus 2y and 3x plus 2y. It's the exact same thing. So how can I take a 3x plus a 2y and get 10? And then somehow take the exact same thing, 3x plus 2y again, and get 2 this time, right? It's not the way I can take 3 times x plus 2 times y and get 10, and then take 3 times x plus 2 times y and get something else, 2. So it felt a little fishy from the beginning. If we try to eliminate it, we get this weird thing that happens here. And if we graph it, we see we have parallel lines, and they'll never cross. And it's the crossing of two graphs that can clue us into the solution to the system. Since they never cross, they don't have any solutions. So getting this 0 equals 8, which is not possible, it's not true, we know that we have no solutions. Right? Now let's take a look at another possibility. To eliminate each other somehow. How do you do that?
I was going to say 2.
First one by 2?
No, the second one by 2.
Multiply this one by 2. And this one by what?
2.
Also by 2?
Yeah.
What's going to cancel out when we do that?
About 18 and 12.
We want to cancel out a variable, not just. Negative 18 and a negative 18.
Oh, sorry, 3 then.
So just do a positive. So we got a negative 18 and a positive 18.
Perfect.
So negative 18 x plus 12 y equals 36. 3 times 6 x is 18 x. 3 times negative 4 y is negative 12 y. 3 times negative 12 is negative 36. Well, now let's see, this will look a little different. And then we'll look at the graph and see what's going on here. Negative 18x plus 18x is 0x. 12y minus 12y is 0, so there's nothing here.
Oh, so it's just 0 then on the graph, just the center, and then even?
Kind of has that feel, but no, that's not going to happen. We get 36 minus 36 is 0. Now, the difference between this result and this result, what's the difference? What do you see? 0 equals 8, 0 equals 0. What's the difference?
That one's true.
That one's true. The other one was false. So this can tell us that actually what we have is infinite. We talked about this.
Yeah, it's the same.
We talked about this in the first section when we looked at the graphs and we said, okay, if we want to find where the graphs can cross, how many ways can they cross? They can cross once. They can cross no times, which you just saw. They could cross infinitely many times.
Oh, I don't know how you do that. It's still end up with 0, 0.
It's the same line.
Okay.
Yeah, no matter
it's
what you plug in for x or y, you're always going to get the same thing. Also, if we look at the graph, so we'll rewrite them in slope-intercept form. I'll rewrite the first one. We got 6x equals, I'm going to write 6y. Add 9x to both sides. We get 6y equals 9x plus 18 divided by 6 on both sides, you get y equals 3 halves x plus 3. And now we're going to go after this second equation. Subtracting 6x from both sides, you get negative 4y equals negative 6x minus 12. Divide by negative 4, we get y equals 3 halves x plus 3. Any similarities between these two?
They both have the same everything.
The same everything. Yeah, exactly. The same everything. So when you go to graph them, everything's the same.
They'll be the same line.
They'll be the same line. We got a line intercept of 3, a slope of 3 halves. Put that in both directions. Back, draw that line. And we'll draw the other one. Okay, let's try to do that. It has a y-intercept of 3, and a slope of 3 halves of 3 over 2. The exact same slope. So I'm going to draw this line, and I just draw the exact same line again. Okay. So how many times do they cross over each other? Many times they cross here and here, 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 everywhere. Anywhere the first line is, the second line is right there. They're the exact same point. So infinitely many solutions. Any solution that works for the first equation works for the second equation. Find a solution that will work in the second one. As opposed to this one, no solutions. There is no way that you will ever get this to work. Okay? Getting these two equations to have a solution that they can share is like trying to make 0 equal 8. It's just not possible. Trying to get a solution that both of these can share is like trying to get 0 equal to 0. It's always true. We'll always have the solution that works in this equation work in this equation as well. So, the short story here is if we use elimination and we get a false statement, there's no way that it'll work. There's no solution. If we wanted doing elimination every, all the variables get eliminated and we get a true statement. And we know there's infinitely many solutions. We know that if I can photograph it, it'd just be the exact same line. We don't have to do elimination. We can do these, and you know, it just kind of, we're not always going to get infinitely or no solutions, but it's in the mix now. Okay, so like as you do your homework, keep in mind infinitely many solutions and no solutions are in the mix.